Welcome to SV Seeker, Sailing Vessel Seeker. My name is Doug, and this is our project. We do all kinds of things. We do casting, a little lathe work, a lot of plasma cutting, some welding, some aluminum work and aluminum welding, aluminum casting. We do all kinds of things, but it all focuses on building this boat. Sometimes we fall and bang ourselves. Sometimes other things fall and break, but it's all good. We are not the channel to watch if you want to learn how to do something meticulously correct. We're the channel to watch if you want to see that amateurs can actually do this. And if you're an amateur DIY, we're the channel for you. Come and join us. It's going to be a lot of fun. All right, this is our shop. We have about everything you need for metalworking. We have a metal lathe. We have a wire welder for aluminum, wire welder for steel. We even do some stick welding every once in a while. A CNC table that we can set up to use for plasma cutting, steel. We can use it for 3D printing. And we have a router on it that we can make patterns with. In fact, I'll show you a pattern over here. We do our own casting too, and this is going to be a cleat for us. We're actually working with a match plate this next time. So the boat is a twin keel design. It's very unusual for a sailboat. Well, yeah, it really is. Two keels on the ground and the skeg or the shoe underneath the rudder, we actually can pull up into a harbor that has a nice hard bottom, hopefully not mud, and wait for the tide to go out, and then we can come outside and do our own maintenance on the boat. Saves a lot of money. One of the things we cast was our propeller blades. We actually bought the shaft and the hub, but it didn't come with propeller blades, so we made our own. The rudder we use is a fishtail rudder. It's a beautiful design. It actually has the ability to come over 45 degrees before it stalls. Now, she's a work boat, so when you walk down her and you look down the hull, she's not really fair, and a really fair hull wouldn't have this bulge out and that little bulge in and out, man. We don't care about that. The idea of the boat is she's a work boat. We expect to run her into things every once in a while and add a few dents. And this year we've made a lot of progress. One of the things we've got done is our masts are all done. Now that catwalk out there is our way of accessing the back of the boat without going through the pilot house. And what they're working on, that gangway will hinge right where those boards are and will lower her down. When I started building this boat, I was doing it by myself. And one of the things that happened was we got people involved, and then we started exploiting that. So now we have lots of people involved. Artists, welders, engineers, you name it, we've got them involved. We see no reason not to make a boat a little more interesting by putting some art on it. But with this hatch open up, we can take people's scientific gear and experiments up and out of there, because there's going to be a crane mounted right here that will swing out over the side, drop it in the water, and bring it back in. This is not your typical sailboat. This is the Chinese junk rig sailboat. So this mast leans forward at 9 degrees, and there's no genoas, there's no jibs, there's no spinnakers. It's just three big sails that go up and down. But this is really the living area. This is where most people will hang out, because it's the kitchen, the dining room table, the living room, all rolled into one. Most people don't put bathrooms on the back deck of their boat, even though it's called the poop deck for a reason. But the reason is we can take on people who are not quite so ambulatory and easy to get up and down the stairs. Oh. And with this here, then, you know, we can cater to lots of other people. So this is our cargo hold, 21 feet long, about 16 feet wide. We've got a bulkhead forward and aft of us here, so you could actually close those watertight doors and flood a section of the boat, and the boat will still stay on the surface. We hope. We think it will. We don't want to try it, actually. Back behind us is the engine room, and the engine room has already been set up so we can have a Cummins 5.9 engine down here. And this cabin is our it's a small cabin. It'll have another bathroom, shower in it, a bed, and back behind is the rudder coming up all through the boat. Let's go take a look at the forward deck. Now, if you're coming on board as a guest or a worker or a researcher, this is where you stay. We're going to split this into two cabins. So it'll be a port and starboard cabin, and then the restroom will be over here with head, shower, in that location. But those bulkheads in the boat are closed up by the watertight doors, and they are dog doors just like you'd see on a military ship, except of course we have a little flair for our arts in it. This is a scale model of the deck of the boat, and we're working on our sails next, and this is the kind of sail that we're going to have, is a junk sail. There'll be three of these. This is the main one, and it'll hang about yay. So we're going to work out where our sheets go, where our blocks go, where the winches go, and all that sort of thing. Now, something we did this year that I'm really happy about is we did all of our portholes. We didn't do the portholes themselves. That's, you know, a half inch worth of glass in there, and all the dogs. These came out of a bar in Boston, I think. So what we did is the deadlights for them. We had one deadlight, and we put in the artwork on the rest of it. So they're the things that we like to see on a daily basis. This one says, "I have no fear of great depths, but great fear of shallow living." And that pretty much sums us up, doesn't it? For the Lao Tzu fans out there, a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we're in Oklahoma, so you gotta have your school bus in your front yard, right? It makes a great storage shed. This one actually donated the engine. We actually had two of them. The other one donated all the windows that'll go around the pilot house. And this is our next project for sometime in the next year. This is the material to make our tender. We're gonna actually build the boat that goes off the smaller boat to go on the back of this big boat.
One boat wasn't enough for you, Doug?
No, one boat's never enough. You've gotta have two, maybe three. You gotta have a lifeboat, don't you? So one of the surprising things that started happening when we started building this boat is other people wanted to come and help. And so we started opening the doors and giving you an invitation. This is our invitation to you to come and help us work on the boat. If you have massive skills, you can come. If you have no skills at all, you can come. It's a sharing crew type environment. So we learn from each other as we go through this process, and we all have fun doing it. There's three rules that we follow here. The first rule is get the job done. The second rule is have fun doing it. If you're not having fun, there's no point in it. And the third rule is safety. Safety's third, which means safety is your problem, not mine. If you expect me to give you a safe environment, I have failed miserably at that. This place is dangerous. So think about what you're doing if you're gonna come, and if you want somebody else to take care of you and you know, give you a tissue to blow your nose, not the place for you, okay? But if you're gonna take care of yourself, come on. There's no pressure to do anything you don't wanna do. In fact, we admire the courage that it takes to say, no, that's beyond my current skill level. So you do that and you're fine. So come on and join the SB Seeker crew.
Get a little undershot of you. Yeah, you look majestic.
I do, right?
You totally
make my
do.
Penis look big, will you?
Okay. Hold on. I got to put it on the big penis filter.
Big penis filter. Okay. Stick it out like. And come on and enjoy us. And come on and. So come on and. I'll say it one more time, right? So come on and. Fuck it.
We'll do it live.
Yeah, we'll do it live. So come on and join us. So come on and join the SB Seeker crew.
Perfect.
That's what I wanted to say.
Yeah.